Hey, how's it going? And today we're going to be exploring the character device, the character devices, and the device controller. And what you can use this for is adding, spicing up your games with NPC-type players that can message you, and then they can also perform a limited repertoire of behaviors or emotions. And maybe 10 or 12 of them. And they can also stand around in idle mode and a couple other poses. But the main thing is that they are able to message you, and then they can also function as triggers for other events. And so you could actually have two characters almost have like a back and forth dialogue a little bit. So let me show you what this looks like. If I come into the game, I'll end the game and start it again real fast so you can see what happened. What's happening here. Okay, so I'm gonna hit escape and hit start game. Okay, so come in here like this, and I've got three of these NPC type, and there's actually, they've added a whole bunch of these now. There's 20 of these characters, if not more. And so this is just a standard mannequin. So if you walk up to them, the big thing is they can message you and say, how are you doing, boss, or ask you a question. And then if you press E, they can trigger any other creative device that there is. They're just like a button. So if you press E, you can make any other event in the game world happen. In this case, though, I'm making this mannequin make that mannequin play air guitar. So when I come up here and I press E, she's gonna play air guitar. And now she's in a front. Now he's over here. He's in an idle animation. And I think that's the one that most of the time the mannequin would be in. This one is in a frozen idle pose right there. Just frozen like a rock. So I don't know why, if you'd want your character to be frozen like that or you want him to be in an idle animation, it's up to you. Now she's rigged so that when I interact with her, he does the air horn. So I press E. And he does the air horn. Now he's frozen in a thumbs up pose, which isn't too bad, I guess. It's probably better. And he's rigged to blow up that can over there. So if I press E for him, that blows up. And that's it. So you can see how much functionality these can add to your game. But because of that, there's a little bit more involved with this than your average device. So I'll be back in just a minute to go over everything. Okay, I'm back. Now to get started with this, I'm just in a blank island template here, and I'm just gonna delete this second spawn because I don't need it. And then what we're gonna do is I'll just come up in here to devices, and I'm gonna search for the characters. And I'm just gonna get three of them. And what I can do here is I can actually, once I have one in the scene, I can just press Alt, click and drag. Let me get my position here. Alt, click and drag, and just get another, make another one, and click and drag and make another one. So I've got three of them there. Okay, and then we also want this controller device right here, and we'll put that over by him. Not too close, but kind of in the proximity. It doesn't have to be touching. And I want to show you something. Notice how they all say 00, because that shows the channels that they're on. So they're all on in character slot 0 right now. So if a message went out to emote, they would all do the same emotion because they're all on the same channel. That's the advantage of this. This allows us to customize basically the emotion messages that get sent out and other messages. So you can think of it almost as these controllers as kind of a channel override so that only certain messages go to certain players. But these don't override everything. They just override those parameters that you want overridden. So in this case, it would override the emote that we have. So if we set the emote on the character here to be one thing, And it's set to something else on the controller, the controller is going to take precedence. So it doesn't matter what we set the emote on here, it's going to do the emote on the controller because that's the channel that we're using it for. Okay, so anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through each one of these and set them up. And then we'll... The other thing that's kind of quirky, and this might change, is that to set the skins on these characters, we can only do that in creative mode. We can't do that from here. So like if I select character device one, you see here there's a drop down, but there's no way for me to switch the skin in here. I have to go into creative mode to switch that. And the last thing, just to spice things up, we'll get that explosive device here. And we'll just drag a little ways off in the distance there, because I literally had it blow the skin off of the character. Okay, so let's start with this guy first. And this guy, we could rename it to be clear, but it's just character device. And we can set an idle animation. We can set a pose. There's a wide range of poses here. So you could do that. Flex, if you want that. It's kind of silly. The animated idols, there's only a few to choose from, so it'd mostly probably be most likely waiting. Apparently you can do custom idols. I haven't explored that yet as far as what custom, because that would be nice to have custom idols in there. His emote could just be, I don't think we're going to have him even emoting, so we don't even have to worry really what his emote is. Now here, interact type is, do you want this character to be able to trigger something else to happen? If that's the case, you want it to be yes. And then here's the advantage of these characters, is that they can give custom messages. So like this one can say, be careful, there is an explosive device out there. Something like that. So he can give a message to the player. And then since he can function as a button, if you, when you press E and he can trigger some other event, well, he can not only trigger another event, he can trigger another NPC to talk. So that's how you could actually have a conversation. He could say, he could trigger this one to react to what he said. So you could, if you set this up right, you could have a little dialogue going on there, which would be cool. And he's on character slot 0, but it doesn't really matter what channel he's on for right now. He's on 0 though. And then he's not going to be doing anything else. I don't think there's any other settings on here that we need to worry about. Okay, so he, just think of him as a button. Now we'll move on to the next one here. And this is our second character. And remember, we'll switch the skins in creative mode. We can't switch the skins right here. So what do we want this person to do? Well, let's just have them be in a frozen pose. What's love hands? Okay. All right, let's just have them do love hands. And what could their emote be? Is their guitar is fine. But it doesn't matter what their emote is, because it's going to be chosen by this one here. So we don't even have to worry about that. And is she receiving a message? She is. She's going to be on channel 1, or they call it character slot 1. So we'll put, so now with that known, we can go ahead and click on this and set it to character slot 1 too. Now whatever the channel of communication is, which is going to be here, it's going to be play emote. No, it's not here. It's going to be here. It's going to be over here. I'm sorry about that. It's going to be, it's a little confusing. So this controller is going to control the emote on here. So we'll put it here as our guitar. And then perform emote. Perform emote. Oh, the command is going to come from, the command is actually going to come from this character here. So this character is going to send to this controller, perform the emote on anyone who's on that channel 1. And this person is on channel 1. So there's actually nothing we need to rig up. Any character that's on channel 1 is going to perform this emote. So the character device is when he's interacted with, he's going to send a message here, perform emote, and the emote is going to be air guitar. And this one's going to do it because they're on channel, they're in character slot 1. And this device is on 1. And that's why it says 1 right there. And so there's nothing else this character needs to do. So now this character is going to trigger this character to emote. So let's go to this character. And what are we going to have them do? Well, Oh, do we have a message for them? Yeah, so we want them to be able to send a message to. And this is where I'm the character device to here. And she can say something like, don't listen to him. He is always worried for no reason. Something like that. So you have a little bit of exchange going on there, right? Okay, so now jumping to this last person, we'll put them in a waiting animation. So we'll go idle animation here, and it'll be waiting. And that's what I would imagine most be. And we could have them do the ground and pound. Is there an emote? But it doesn't matter because they're going to do what the controller device does. So it doesn't really matter what that is. But this is the most important thing, is that they're on slot 2. So we put that on slot 2. And there's nothing else we need to do here. So we click here on this device, on the controller device. And the most important thing is we want to set the channel to 2. And the emote is, this is the emote that's going to take precedence, is the ground and pound here. And they're going, this is going to trigger, this controller device is going to trigger to perform the emote when this character is interacted with. So that's the trigger, is character device 2. So go to character device 2, and that is on interacted with. There we go. So this character is going to trigger this controller. This controller's emotion is going to, because they're on the same channel as this character's on slot 1, it's going to trigger the emote here. When this character's interacted with, they're going to trigger this controller, and that's going to be the ground and pound one. And because this guy's on channel 2, he's going to do whatever that emote is. Now this guy is our character device 3. So if we select our explosive device way off here in the middle of nowhere, we can come down here and say explode on character device 3 on interacted with. So now he, when he's interacted with, I can have him say a little message now. So this one's, that's all we need to do there. Click back on here, and then this one's message, he has to be sent to send event 2. And he can say, believe what you see, or something like that. Okay, and as far as I know, that's everything set up. So I hope that's clear. It's this line of communication of what's going on. So the last thing we need to do is just set the skins, because we can't set them in here. So I'm going to go ahead, and we did a lot of changes here. So let's go ahead and push those changes. And then I'll be back just as soon as that's done. Okay, the session updated. I want to make one other thing clear, is that when you're setting this up, it's best to set everything up in the editor and not really in creative mode. So I only set things up in creative mode, like the skins, if I really don't have a choice, because it seems like the editor takes precedence over the creative mode. So let's go into creative mode here and set the skins, and then we should be done. So then this part's pretty cool. We can just walk up here and it says E, customize character. And look at all the look at all the options we have. So let's just do, I don't even know who all these are. I haven't even looked at them all. Gia, let's just do Gia for that one. And then let's go to the next one. E. And I'm just still making my way through all of them. Goldie, Sizzle Sergeant, I don't know what that is. Okay, and then last one is this one, E, and yeah, they've added a ton of these. Let's just do the Night Witch one. I think that one was cool. Okay, so we've got everybody here, and if this is right, if we just look right now, you can see she is in idle animation. She's in the love pose, and she's in idle animation too. Okay, so what should happen? She's got a message. We don't see it just yet, but they all have messages. So this one should trigger this one to emote. this one should trigger this one to emote, and this one will trigger the explosion off in the distance. So let's see if that's what happens. Game mode, let's see. Let me come in here and let's see what she says. Be careful, there is an explosive device out there. And then I press E. She's playing air guitar. Don't listen to him, he's always worried for no reason. Oh, that was before. Okay, now she should trigger this one. So I press E. Let's see what happened here. I'm pressing E, but nothing's happening. So where's the breakdown? Let me stop. Where's the breakdown? Let me go into creative mode. I pressed E and nothing happened. So let's see. This is it. Oh, I didn't set the. I must have set the wrong thing here. So see, look, I didn't set the, on the controller here, I didn't set the perform emote. So this needs to be set to the character device 2 and on interacted with. So that's simple enough. I think I can save that. I think because it's just an array, I don't need to push changes. So let's go back in and see if it works now. Sorry about that. There's a lot of little things. Okay, so idle animation, be careful. There is an explosive device out there. She triggers her into her guitar. Don't listen to him. He is always worried for no reason. She does the ground and pound. Believe what you see. E. And that's it. Yep. So anyway, I hope you found this helpful. I really do feel like this adds a level of complexity to the games and interaction that could really be helpful. So I do appreciate you watching. And if you're not subscribed, I do appreciate each and every person that subscribes. So thanks and have a great day.